Hey, this is something I wrote 2 years ago, so don't judge me. Or, I guess, go ahead and judge me. I don't really have any say in the matter. A t-shirt. And it's the doctor. And, yay! I like t-shirts. I got a new t-shirt, EA.
Introductory type video.
Promptly at 8:15, I walked through the mahogany door. The room at the top of the stairs is dark burgundy color covered in paintings and artwork with a faded marble fireplace. The room was covered in a thick layer of dust. One picture catches my eye. It is of a young boy whose mouth is open in a silent scream. His hands seem to beat the paint of his frozen prison. As I sit, a cloud of dust explodes around me. I could not see a thing. As the old cuckoo clock in the corner struck 9, the little bird came out to the oddly familiar tune. I saw a shadow pass along the wall. An animal crawled into my line of sight. The animal had matted gray fur and gigantic yellow eyes. Its long, untrimmed nails pitter-pattered against the hard floor. It growled low sound to inform me about my trespassing on his territory. After staring at me, waiting to see what I would do for what seemed like an eternity, it made its way out, still growling, and turned back to stare his large eyes at me once before it left. At 10, when a large green ball of mucus was rolling slowly until it bumped into a table, which seemed to disintegrate the moment it was touched by the green goo, it picked up speed as it was destroying objects. I jumped from the couch and ran toward the wall and away from the giant ball. The ball came within an inch of where I was cowering in fear. Then it just started to roll backwards and I run to the door. But as I race down the stairs, a young boy stumbles from the front door. It is the same boy from the painting, I realize. The boy's eyes don't have as much pain in them, though. I race up the stairs to the room I was in and grab the painting. The boy is lurching toward the stairs. He has a green tint to his skin, and there are red, bloody marks and muddy fingerprints around his neck. His hands are covered in scratches. I realize that I am seeing him dying, but I have no idea how to save him. He grabs a portrait from my hands, and with one quick motion, it collides with his head. The boy disappeared, and the painting sat on the floor. The painting had changed, though. Instead of the look of terror on the boy's face, it had a certain peace to it, as if after years of torture, the boy had finally been put to rest. That was fascinating. I know. Oh, God. I'm so sorry to Mrs. Hugole that she had to read that. She didn't deserve that at all. Oy. Poor Mrs. Hugole. I'm sorry for me in the past terrible writing that you were forced to read. Sorry. Okay. Well, remember that time we met out with a fish?